Hello everyone, I hope you all are fine. So in our today's session, we are going to start the study of application of colloid. After the completion of the study of application of colloid, then your chapter surface chemistry will be finished, and in our next session, we will start the next chapter. So the first application, it is of medicine. So most of in the pharmaceutical preparation, colloidal solutions are to be used. So the first colloidal solution of antimony, this is used in curing Kala-Azar disease. Kala-Azar disease, most probably it leaves the bad effect on liver and the bone marrow. So the medicine which we are using for the treatment of Kala-Azar, this is a colloidal solution of antimony. Next is to be of erigrol. Erigrol, actually it is used as an eye lotion. And this is a colloidal sol of silver, which is to be protected by the gelatin. Okay. Now, so here we must know that the silver sol is to be used in eye lotion, and that in which is to be protected by the gelatin, and in a combined form, it is to be known as erigrol. Okay. Now, next is to be of milk of magnesia. Actually, what is the milk of magnesia? Whenever magnesium hydroxide is to be dissolved in water, then we get a colloidal solution that we call it, this is milk of magnesia. It is used for the treatment of stomach problem, or you can say stomach disorder. Or this milk of magnesia act as a good antacid also. It act against the acidity. Now the next is to be of intramuscular injections. In intramuscular injection, a colloidal sol of gold and calcium is to be used, which provides the strength to our muscles. Okay, so now let's come on the next application of colloid in the industrial products like paint. Paint, it is of, here the dispersed phase is of solid and dispersion medium is of liquid. So this is also of colloid. Ink, rubber, synthetic plastic, cement, graphite lubricants, they all are the colloidal solution which are to be used as an industrial products. Okay, now the next, the very important thing which I am going to discuss, this is purification of drinking water. So in the purification of drinking water, we use the alum, and this alum is to be put in a muddy water. Suppose you are having a muddy water and you are putting a alum, then what happens, all the mud which is present in the water, that settles down on the bottom, and the clear layer of water that starts to form on the top. In this way, we make the water purify. So actually what happens in this process, mud which is present in a river water. So in a river water, mud is present which is negatively charged. And the formula of alum is to be K2SO4, Al2SO4 whole thrice dot 24 moles of water. Here the water of crystallization is of 24. Alum provides the aluminium ion which is positively charged. When this positively charged aluminium ion comes in contact with the negatively charged mud, they both get, due to mutual coagulation, they get neutralized and they precipitate out and settles down on the bottom, and finally the clear layer left on the top, and this can be decanted off. In this way, the alum is to be used to pure drinking water. Actually, mud is here colloidal solution, that we must know that. Okay, now the next is to be the important point which we have to understand. Cleansing action of soap and detergent also act in colloidal solution. Whenever the soaps and detergents are to be dissolved in water, they always form a colloidal solution. Okay, now this is not a true solution because it is not completely transparent. Okay, now the next is to be of rubber. We have to understand all the information about rubber. Rubber we prepare from the latex. Latex is a very sticky substance which we get from the rubber tree. Actually, latex is a colloidal solution. It is not simply in a general form, it is not usable. So rubber is to be obtained by the coagulation. So the coagulation of latex is to be done, and it is to be converted into a rubber which is more usable, and that is most probably it is to be used in tire, tubes, ropes, toys. Okay. So here we have to understand latex is a colloidal solution. Okay, so now the next is to be of tanning. Tanning is what procedure, what process? Actually, the animal hide, whenever it is to be put in the tannin. So here two words we have to understand, what is hide here and what is tannin here. Hide, it is a German word. Its mean is to be of haut. Haut means skin. So it animal hide, actually it is of animal skin. Animal skin, it is colloidal in the nature, here we have to understand. This is of positively charged. Okay, tannin is a solution which most probably we get from the bark of tree and the wood. When this animal hide is to be dipped in tannin, tannin is negatively charged. Positive and negative charge, they come in contact with each other and the mutual coagulation takes place and the leather starts to get harder. Hardening of leather takes place and this process is to be known as tanning. Okay, now here the one important point which you have to understand, sometime chromium salt used as a tannin, okay, in which we dip animal hide to make it harden. Okay, now the next which we have to understand, the photographic plate. So the photographic plate is coated with a layer of emulsion. Emulsion, it is also a form of colloid, where the dispersed phase and the dispersion medium both are liquid. Okay, and the light sensitive silver bromide in gelatin over the glass plate is to be used in photographic plate. Okay, so I think you all have got that point. Okay, next is to be of electrical precipitation of smoke, which you have to understand. Actually, what is a smoke? A smoke is a colloidal solution of solid particle in which carbon, arsenic and dust are suspended in air. Whenever the smoke is to be passed through oppositively charged plate, the smoke starts to lose its charges, okay, and it gets neutralized and it settles down on the bottom. Okay, it settles down on the bottom. This we have to understand. Okay, so the same procedure, it happens in the quartile smoke precipitator, which you have to understand with the help of figure. So in this procedure, what we do, you see here, here we are having a quartile smoke precipitator. We have to take a electrode. It is to be connected with a high voltage battery and its capability is to provide more than 30,000 volt. Okay. And from here, smoke is to be passed and all the dust particle, when they come in contact with a charged electrode, they start to lose their charge and start to coagulate on the bottom and settles in the form of precipitated ash. Okay, and the pure gases free from carbon particle comes out from here. So in this way, quartile smoke precipitator works. I mean to say, quartile smoke precipitator helps in the purification of air and it settles down all the carbon particles on the bottom. Okay, so I think you all have got it, the complete procedure of quartile smoke precipitator, and you got all the application of colloidal solution. That's all for today's. Okay.